A smarter investment objective, literally. S-M-A-R-T-E-R. What does it mean? Alright, first you identify your investment objective, knowing that this purpose is retirement. Your objective is to have 1.5 million for your retirement, and you are prepared to invest in your equities and bonds. That's objective. Then, next question, do you have a strategy? So strategy is lump sum, followed by regular savings of 1,002 per month, and allocation of 80-20. Okay, next thing, how would you monitor? M for monitor. So you need to monitor, is it a quarterly report that you're getting? Annual review with someone, right? Is it an online platform? Is that your monitoring tools, okay? Besides that, then do you have an advisor? Some people take their friends as advisor because he looks intelligent. You make him your advisor, okay? Some will use conferences like this, find other advisors can help you. Through the internet, right? Good and bad advisors come off there. Fund managers, right? And trusted or licensed financial advisor, look for them, okay? Now, other areas like risk tolerance, you are a growth investor and you are prepared to take negative 25% hit. Anything beyond that, cut loss, maybe. Okay, that could be a risk tolerance. Then your time horizon, just now we've done through the exercise, right? Expectation management. Now, this is the most important part of this whole framework that you're setting. You first determine your expected rate of return. Okay, secondly, then you determine what are the situations you would do that makes you change. Okay, the only time when you change this is when you change your objective. So if you don't intend to retire, yeah, you can stop doing this. So last 12 months when the market crashed, many people just stopped investing altogether, stopped doing any planning for retirement. Why? Don't you want to retire? Okay, so this is very important. Now, the important part is called this thing, it's called adjusting. Alright, the amount of investment is what you should first adjust. If market is bad, you can maybe want to invest more because it's cheap. You can adjust the amount. Second thing of adjustment is when you invest. Then the third area is what you invest in. Okay, so you can change from vehicle during market crashes and not just pull out and stay out. Okay, the last area you need to ask yourself or consult an advisor to ask whether your framework is reasonable or realistic. Okay, because we think about it, we always think we are very smart, right? So again, check with someone to validate this. Now for speculators in this room, this framework can also help you well, right? Let's say your objective, speculating, 20,000, and you go on option trading, right? Lump sum investment, you're prepared with a capital of 10,000. You're prepared to do a 5-time leverage and your focal point will be TA, technical analysis. Why not? That be your framework. Why expectation, 2 years to achieve 20,000, why not? But if you don't have a framework, you'll be always asking around, people tell you this, right? You think it's nice, you do it, right? Down there, you hear some news, you do something like that. So because of that, you got, you know, the lalang syndrome, the wind blows, you follow, right? So this is where for 7 other investors over a 20 years period. Now, this is a study done by Yale University, right? For a group of people that have done this exercise and set up their framework, they outperform 97% of their peers in investing. Now, generally, people who do this are happier, more confident, and well-adjusted when market change because you already have a framework knowing that the market will change. So you're a lot more prepared when this happens, right? So with all this said, really it's very important for you to understand yourself, right, your goals and your objective, okay? So with this, this could be your first step to your financial wealth. So again, to literate, high emotion equals to low IQ, okay? With that, what we want to do right now is to help me to collect feedbacks. In this folder that you have, there's a feedback form. Now this feedback is quite valuable for us so that we can think and plan better for the next sessions or next year that we have. Right, so do help me fill this up. And if you got any comments that you'd like to write to me, there's a column that you can write specifically to me. You need me to answer, I will respond to you. Okay? So there are some of the helpers to collect this feedback, so you can pass it to them before you step off this place. Right? Now, for those of you who don't have the folder, okay, and you want this framework that we have, later on, I will be at our booth D23, right, D23 are both there. We will give you this folder, right? We ran out of folders. We prepared a lot, but we ran out of folders. We have this goal setting framework, a smarter investment objective. Do come and see me later on, and thank you for your feedback. My name is Paul. Thank you.